see. Not even winnable.
Alright. I'll be on the play.
That's step one.
Yep, that is step one.
Step one beating any tempo deck is going first.
green screen behind us next time.
Yeah.
I was gonna
my
try
hand.
To run out of time. I need to
my hand.
Probably keeping this.
And I'm gonna mulligan this. No. Don't have any threats. Only have one colored mana. I mean, I do have Ponder and Brainstorm, but I want to kind of tempo first, right?
Yeah.
I don't know if that hand is not unkeepable.
It's not unkeepable, and obviously, if you know what type of deck I'm playing, then that makes it a bit more. But I'd say not having having a Ponder turn one is okay. But
yeah, I just think having the removal that you had, Brent, I think it's kind of where you wanted to be. And then you had Force of Will for his
turn one play.
Chalice, yeah.
Chalice.
Or Chalice or Vial or, you know.
It's tough to say. I mean,
yeah.
I think, you look at that hand and you see, oh, I can go a lot of places with this hand. But then you get in that trap sometimes where you keep hands that don't do anything on their own. I have Abrupt Decay and I think Force of Will, but if you're pitching your Brainstorm to Force,
yeah.
Or whatever you draw off your Ponder, it's and then you're left with basically an Abrupt Decay and a Fatal Push, which those cards are good against this particular deck. But is it going to be enough is the question.
Yeah.
Are you guys up for a mini FNM tonight out of the four of us?
Sure.
I'll do that? Okay.
Mini tournament. Guess it'd be WNM, right?
I guess you're right.
Alright, I'll keep this right. Go ahead.
Island.
I'm gonna float one.
Mm-hmm.
Days.
What color are you floating, Brett?
I'm floating blue.
Okay. All right, I can't do that. That's awful. I'll just let it resolve. You have a mana floating.
Mm-hmm. Go ahead. before we go to the next.
Yeah, yeah, that's fine. I think I'm okay with that anyway. Probably would just let that resolve.
It's two on top.
You just cut okay. Your heads.
Draw?
Yeah. So I think, since I basically have a turn two play that's pretty similar to my turn one play, I don't really care. I have redundancy, so I don't really care about my draw. I don't know why I wanted to date it anyway. But, and then he's kind of behind the turn now, so that gives me the advantage. I guess I was thinking that if I stick the Vial on turn one, it would get, in the long run, I have more of an advantage mana-wise.
Delver?
I basically want to be on the initiative, counter his stuff when I can, because my days isn't going to be good in the long run.
Yeah.
So
creature,
instant
land?
Yeah.
So he's a
four.
Four.
Just put it above him.
Yeah.
That way.
Let's use the gray dice.
Yeah.
Or just this.
I also
you can only see 4 or 5. All right, so we need to make a list of things we need.
So now is an interesting part of the game. Like, they're trying to establish their boards, and...
Well, it's actually kind of an interesting position, because if you're not familiar with the format, you'd think that Brent was pretty far ahead. And having a 4-5 is, you know, a good thing. But, like, that vial up just represents so much strength on a-sper's side.
About to kill your vial?
Until he does something like that. it's almost like I made that happen. So he gets a little value out of it, though. Gets a curse catcher before it goes away. Best you can do.
Yeah.
Making the best out of a bad situation.
Yeah, but with a-sper... Oh, never mind. Now he's got double blue.
That's a good card. And that will stop any size voice.
Yeah.
I don't want you. Go ahead. I'll choose you, by the way.
Yeah.
I choose you!
Go ahead. So let's see if a-sper can lay a lord down and really just get ahead points damage.
Three.
Doesn't look like he has one. I imagine he would have played it before.
Oh, but instead he has no turn.
That's also a solid plan.
Choose you again.
Yeah, in case you're confused, he chose Brent.
Pretty good.
That's a good card, but it unfortunately gets the two true names.
And then Brent doesn't.
Yeah, Fokker guy.
Yeah. See, I like the way Brent plays the Delver. Actually, reach in and flip that sleeve. I think that's the way God meant it to be.
yeah, he needed it to flip that turn for sure.
Swing for three.
Because now he has the choice of either eating creatures or dealing damage. So he's. Somewhat ahead at this point.
Yeah. A fatal push for Curse Catcher.
I'll suck it.
I won't pay extra. Go ahead.
Hey, yeah, the green Stogry? The greenest ogre. Got it. I'm stupid. Thanks for following, buddy.
The green Stogry?
Dumb.
We appreciate the follow. Thanks, man.
Six?
Yeah.
Go ahead. In the turn, I'm going to eat your...
Yeah.
That's fine. Draw?
Yeah.
Swing for 7.
It's an ace.
It's an ace.
I'll block.
Okay, cool. Take 3.
So that's pretty bad for Brandon tempo. Department.
Go ahead.
A little bit.
Because they were both, you know, taking haymakers, and I don't know if he expected them not to block there, but. Tide is turning.
Okay.
The cavern is on Merfolk.
Yeah.
Send one?
Yeah.
I'll eat your case.
Yeah. I think that's good. He doesn't want to shrink his own boy. I mean, it kind of doesn't matter because I have a shrink him up. But he's only going to get one more eat.
Ball is in here.
Yeah.
So he takes out the mute ball, which seems like a pretty good play.
Yep. I'll swing for 3.
Okay.
puts him in a pretty good position.
Depends what he draws here.
It's not what I want. Soldier.
Does that do?
Draws him a card. He can reveal Merfolk, so it only casts two. It costs three more.
Yeah.
Okay. He doesn't. No, it's card something. What is it?
Oh, cards.
Six.
Go ahead.
I'll eat Fiddle Push.
Sure.
Yeah.
Swing three.
Yeah.
So,
Bugdelver pulled it off.
Bugdelver did pull it off. A-sper was drawing dead, though. I mean, I think he drew like four lands in a row.
Yeah,
that's
pretty bad.
Yeah. So, blue decks that don't play Brainstorm, huh? So, I mean, has there ever been a thought? And again, I'm not a Merfolk player, so I don't ever know this discussion was ever had of playing Brainstorm in. I know you don't play fetches, so that's like the reason not to.
There was a version recently that I saw that played black for sideboard cards, and then it wasn't playing. It was playing fetches, and it didn't play Brainstorm. So I was like, if you're gonna play fetches and you're gonna play black, you might as well play Brainstorm, and then you might as well just play a different deck.
Right.
Right. Is there is there any time you just play Ponder because it's better because it has the shuffle built in?
I just don't, you just don't need those types of cards.
Sure.
Like, every card in your deck does something. Like, honestly, the only card that I like that draws cards that the deck didn't, that most people don't play is the land, the Seagate Wreckage, which I've liked. Like, it didn't work out that game because I kept drawing lands, but that doesn't always happen. So, it's...
Generally
speaking, it's like your land, your Mutant Vaults are creatures. Your lands are you can like hard cast your forces. It's pretty rare where you draw that many lands and not any spells that draw cards, or like all I needed was one Lord there and then he would have been dead. You know, so it's like, I don't know. It seems like a very corner case scenario where you're actually just out of gas. But it does happen sometimes, and that's just kind of what the deck is supposed to kind of try to lock you out with chalice or counter spells, and then just kill you with like one true name or one, you know, a true name,
or just go wide with a bunch of dudes.
Yeah, or
and
just
then,
or just like play three lords and then they're unblockable and they can't kill it.
Brent, I don't think that Golgari Charm is good.
What? -1/-1?
There's
for
only
true names.
Yeah, I guess like, if I don't have a lord, but
yeah,
it's kind of hard to say. Like maybe you have to bring it in and just hope. But
and
I'd probably take
enough removal to like remove a lord and then hope to get.
I'd probably take out another Daze over that Leovold.
You think so? What can he target me with?
Well, it's not, I don't think it's necessarily that. It's just that Daze isn't very good with his Cavern Souls.
Yeah.
And vials.
And vials. Yeah.
On the draw, I'd try to cut as many Dazes as possible.
Yeah.
Generally speaking.
Like, what else do you have in your sideboard?
Nothing I think would be really too good in this matchup. I have Craft Digger's Cage, which is not really that good. Another Leovold, couple Thought Seizes, a couple Jaces, two Surgicals, two Flusterstorms, Dreadnought.
Yeah, right.
Vidillion Click and Sylvan Library.
I mean, Sylvan Library and Vidillion Click aren't the worst.
Well, like, if you're basically, the question is, like, is any of those better than Daze? I mean, like, Thoughtseize is probably a strict upgrade.
Hey, Mon, thank you for joining us, dude. Appreciate it.
What's up, buddy? Thanks, man.
Thanks for the compliment. Yeah, I just don't think that Daze is good, and I think that... I don't even know if Thoughtseize is...
I mean, I'm just saying, like, it you know... Because
Thoughtseize is a horrible top deck, right? But Sylvan Library is not.
I mean, Sylvan Library I would put in.
Sylvan Library is fine. Thoughtseize is bad because... You're trying to, like...
Race, right?
You're trying to race, but that's, like... That's not a race card. That's, like, a...
I'm getting rid
of your combo card. Yeah, it's like it's not really.
What about Click being able to fly over?
Click is okay.
Yeah,
I mean at this point you want stuff that kills GTAs and back to basics because those are the cards that I'm bringing in.
Right, which he already has in Abrupt Decay.
You have Abrupt Decays, and I mean, that Golgari farm can kill back basics, so it's not the worst.
Yeah.
Like, at this point, I'm turning into, like, a semi-control deck. Like, I'm kind of switching gears. Like, obviously, I'm still going to play all my creatures. I'm not going to cut any creatures. But, like, I'm playing Chalices, Dazes on the play, back to basics. Like, I'm just going to try to lock out the game as quickly as possible. Like, I'm probably, like, my cuts are pretty easy. Like, I almost always cut forces on the play and then Dazes on the draw.
On the draw.
Yeah, that's just how the deck kind of plays.
Yeah, same on my side, pretty much.
Yeah, and then if he plays a lot of removal, Phantasmal Images can be kind of bad. I'm only on the two Phantasmal Image plan. I think it's... Like, I just play more True Names instead.
Which is most of the time what you want Phantasmal Image to be anyway.
Yeah, exactly. That's kind of my mentality. Like, I understand there are times when you copy your Lord and it's just, it's GG, or you copy your Silver Goliath and it's pretty good. You can flash it in and copy their guys. But I generally speaking, it hasn't been the best card, but it's been fine. So I've been playing too. But... I could see upping that count too, and that's, I think people kind of don't realize that, like, Merfolk actually has a lot of play to it, and that it's not like I rarely see a deck that's exactly like mine, and I rarely see the same deck being played.
Crimson Viper, welcome back, dude. Appreciate you hanging out with us tonight. Legacy is the best format. That's what Legacy is.
What is Legacy?
What is Legacy?
That is the question.
I mean, just watch the video of French and I arguing, like, what was that, like, our, like, third stream?
I like that.
What were you guys arguing about?
It got kind of bad, because it was, like, tensions got a little high, and
no,
it was just, like...
It was just, like, we were just going in circles, that was the problem. Like,
yeah.
Frenchie just basically wanted to...
Drunkenly...
Yeah, there was alcohol involved.
Drunkenly,
so.
We were trying to say when you should, like, vial something in, when you know that, like, your opponent is just gonna, like, it was gonna vial it in, and then it was gonna get killed immediately.
I was,
but
okay,
saying,
so, no, it was, when do I use the removal spell, and I was waiting for you to cast Mother Runes at end step. Right? Vial it in Mother Runes at end step. The reason behind that is because I wanted to hit it while I was summoning sick. And then, so instead, he didn't do anything. Went to his upkeep, I upkeeped Abrupt Decayed it. And then the question became, why didn't I do that at end step versus the beginning of his upkeep? And the answer was because I wanted one more round of Mother Runes and summoning sickness.
If I was going to vial it in.
Yeah, if he was
going to. And if I was playing around. Like, there were just a bunch of, like, stipulations, basically. And then Frenchie was like, you just don't want him to have, like, the option. You should force him to do it. And then, like, he was like, the way I was playing, he was saying that I didn't have any white mana, so I would almost definitely, like, have, like, done it a different way, but that just wasn't true. I actually just had, a Caracas in my hand, and I didn't want it to get wastelanded. So I was like, I was playing in a particular way, and then he just kept saying that, like, I wouldn't play that way, and I was like, well, no, I did play that way. Like, I played that way on purpose. But, like, it ended up not mattering, and he was just saying that, like, the format is such that you need to, like, get a mana advantage. Like, everything is, like, you're trying to play the cheapest spells, you're trying to, you know, use free counter spells to counter their spells, and, like, in a myriad of ways, and, like, he wasn't wrong, it's just his logic in that instance didn't really make... It wasn't even, like, related to what we were talking about. So it was, like, it just kind of didn't make any sense.
Crimson Viper says, I vote for you guys. I vote you guys for supreme leaders of the universe, and I will defend you all to the death.
Yay!
Of my pie, which is already 3/4 gone.
Nice.
What's going on, Brenton?
So this is my hand right here.
My hand.
I'm going to mulligan this hand. Again, I got... shit ton of lands that you don't really want. And, I mean, I got Ponder turn one, but then I had no interaction with you for a while.
Yeah, you're on the draw, too, so...
Yeah.
I think... people think that, like, with decks that are kind of more attrition-y, that you don't want to mulligan ever. Because, like, you know, you're like, oh, well, I'm playing a combo deck, I should mulligan to my combo. It does feel more intuitive, but you should, when you're playing, you know, a Delver deck, you want to play a Delver on turn one. You want to be doing something active.
Yeah, Delver or Deathrite.
Yeah,
you know.
you want those things, and I can understand, like, it feels bad when you mulligan, you know, an okay hand, and you get a worse hand, but it's like, you probably weren't going to win with that okay hand necessarily.
And I
like, if you didn't mulligan, if you kept the other hand, you probably would have lost the last game.
Yeah.
Because I would have just had two vials and all my stuff would have come out faster, and like, I don't know, it just felt like the game would have been better for me if you had kept the first hand.
So Boner says, Sloan, you suck.
Sloan in chat?
No.
No. I don't. Simon. He could be in chat, but yeah, no, that's just Simon.
Oh,
Simon's
Boner.
Yeah, so
Boner. He just says that every time.
Yeah, he just says that every time.
What's up, Kim Simon?
How do you like all the miracles, Simon? You get the miracle
unlimited again.
Unlimited again.
Everybody's so stoked.
God, that limited format's gonna suck.
Yeah. Like, it's probably why they didn't have a GP, right? They just like, let's just cram a bunch of good cards and not really like support limited format.
I mean, I'll still
play. So this is my hand.
Because I love
much better. I'm glad I mulligan, so I'm gonna keep that.
All right. So your scry.
Yep.
You get the scry. Did he forget to scry last?
I think he forgot to scry.
Yeah,
no, I scryed.
Oh, yeah.
And I scryed to the bottom.
Okay.
I scryed to the bottom again.
Okay. I didn't even see if he scryed.
Yeah.
I was just like, file.
I did?
Yeah.
Turn one Delver.
Sure.
Go ahead.
Okay. That's always what you want. I never want that Delver to flip. Another Delver. Okay.
That was a really risky play on Brent's part. Unless he had removal in hand.
A-sper
could have filed in a Chris Catcher and just totally punched him.
Well, I would Chris Catcher into a Lord, and then is what I would want to do. Merfolk.
Okay.
Oh, that's the actual combo.
Yeah, that's just ugly.
I will say no.
You hate to see that. fetch.
Okay. I'm sorry. I don't know. Your life goes down. Not mine.
Yeah. That'd be pretty sweet. Fetch, you lose your life.
Yep.
I will play Wasteland and then my own true name. Naming you.
Alright.
I choose you.
Still think Brent is in a really bad spot here.
Go ahead.
Take this up to three. Draw. So I have choices. Question is, I think it's probably the right time, honestly. So back to basics.
Ooh. It's pretty good.
So my non-basic lands don't untap, right?
Yes, non-basic.
Non-basic lands.
And I'm not sure if I'm supposed to leave. I think I kind of want to leave the cavern untapped because I can just land one of my lords, because this is at three right now. So I want to land one of my lords, and the Muta Vault, it'll just have to stay tapped. But I'm going to have more mana than he is, hopefully, for the rest of the game. I'm going to tap.
I'll take three.
So you go.
Does not untap, man.
Oh, yeah. Sure.
Yeah.
That's how you win this game. God, this is just, like, not good.
Yeah, so now he has to, like, spend his turn, like, corrupt the king if he has it, which I doubt it, since Ajite's been on the table for a while.
Yeah.
The vial's been on the table.
Swing.
Yeah, take care.
Oh, this is just so ugly. Go ahead.
It's not getting any better.
Oh.
No.
Okay.
So these islands come into play.
Crimson Viper says, I hate when you organize your deck for tuning. I hate that I have to see what I'm building and not look at it in paper. Do you play a lot of Moto? Is that why?
One of them. Attack.
Six. Ten.
Trigger. So if you had a Golgari Tron, you would have done it. So probably just gonna kill the Death Rite at this point. Try to choke his mana.
Yeah.
Okay.
Nope, does not attack.
Trigger.
Yeah.
Yay!
Way too late, oh no!
Oh, no.
I'm just like dead though.
Not quite.
Yeah, I mean, so I swing back at for six.
Six, yeah.
Then, pass turn.
Oh, okay, so, no, he only plays the paper, but he says he's a little retarded. I have to see it. I can't just look at it on paper. So,
So
what you mean is that like you can't come up with a concept and write it down and then see how it visually plays out. You'd rather have to like. I think all of us have that, right? Like that's just a part of.
It depends if you're more visual or if you're more like mental. So I can look at I can like remember what my deck list looks like and then kind of work off that sometimes. But it does help to have a visual. I think you get to like you. It's, like, easier to connect the lines. It's like when, like, detectives or whatever in those shows, they have, like, the board, and then they connect the lines physically.
Yeah.
It's just, like, it gives you like, an actual, like, tangible thing to like, touch and move, and, like, that can be very helpful, I think.
It helps organize your thoughts.
Yeah, yeah. It's, like, if it's in your head, then you have to remember every single thing, but if you
yeah.
can, like, when you take down notes, like, you can refer to your notes. It's like a little bit easier, and I don't think that's a bad thing necessarily. It's just, I understand the time consumption.
Well, for like for me personally, I'll fall in love with a card, and I'll think it'll be good in a certain deck. But I actually have to play test it. I have to like get that muscle memory of it to really know if it's good or not.
Lance.
Well, yeah. Lance
you just did.
Yeah,
just
I mean, sometimes you just draw all the good cards in your deck.
Like the three creatures I can't fatal push.
Yep. Yeah, I mean, I think there's something to like, you know, looking at other people's deck lists and like trying to think of like and like try things out. But I'm definitely a proponent of like. If something's working, don't just change it because you see other people doing it. Doesn't necessarily mean it's the right choice. But
right.
It can be difficult when, like, it seems like there's a huge, like, meta shift or something. And then people start, like, playing these cards that you're like, wow, I would never have, like, played that card. But, like, you know, trying it out doesn't hurt. But, like, I wouldn't go into a tournament with, like, switching around a fundamental part of your deck.
Right, without having the... The grind sesh of really, like, testing to see if it's good or not.
Yeah.
Like, a key example is a lot of lists for Aberlone were putting one of Deathrite Shaman in the main board. I hated that idea for a long time. I just thought that, well, you're playing Chalice for one. Why would you, if you ever top deck that with a Chalice out, like, it's just the worst. So on and so forth. Well, I started playing with it recently, and I love it. Having another turn one play is amazing. Green Sun's Ending for one. And there's so many spots to help fix your mana because the four color mana base, like, it just
yeah.
it
can give you like some it's like since you're playing Green Sun Zenith, it gives you like another attack, a level of attack, which the deck already has so many.
Right.
So like you can gain life or you know start draining them. Like,
so, and I do that all the time, right? Like, I, with, like, lands, I thought that Ghost Quarter was just awful. I'm going to play lands tonight, and I'm going back to the Rishon Port plan because I think it's a little bit better, but it actually wasn't as bad as I initially thought it was.
Especially against Delver decks that don't play any basic lands.
Yeah. Ghost Quarter is just Strip Mine.
Yeah.
Or Wasteland, I mean.
Yeah. Yeah, but like against a Merfolk deck, it's not as crippling.
No.
Yeah, it's better to tap down with Rishon Port than it is to try to Ghost Quarter them over and over again until they're out of blue sources.
Yeah.
Which is, the idea behind it was to do that to Miracles, right? Was to just keep them off their white and then combo off as soon as they're out of white sources.
Yeah.
But
which is it's still an option.
Yeah.
Yeah.
Which is fine, but I don't think it should be the reason that you play Ghost Quarter.
Right.
Necessarily.
Why can't we just play them all?
Yeah. Just play 64
and
cards.
Sinkhole.
I mean, if you're that like land ad nauseum deck, you're basically trying to play it all.
That's right.
Like, you're trying to do everything.
It's a pretty unfortunate hand you have there, Brent.
I know. So, this is a definite mulligan?
Ship.
So,
it's going to Philadelphia.
Minus the no lander.
Same here.
Brent, you can't do that anymore.
Judge?
Really?
Yeah.
Judge?
You can only do it at the beginning of each game.
Okay.
No, I thought it was once per game.
Nope.
Or basically, it's just at the beginning of each game. You can do it once.
You can do it once, yeah. And the only purpose behind it is to count how many cards you have in your deck.
Yeah, it's not a sufficient way to randomize your deck. I think people use it to declump their deck, but it doesn't really even do that, so...
Yeah.
I mean, if there was any way to shuffle and not make your deck random, then that would be cheating, so the point is to make your deck random.
Yeah. Yeah, I think the idea
people
is...
People complain
like,
about, like, it's like, oh, I got mana screwed. It's like, well, yeah, that's part of the game. It's like, yeah, if you were shuffling away and you never got mana screwed, then you're not playing the game correctly. Well,
right.
You're cheating.
Yeah.
Yeah, I would riffle shuffle if I wasn't so scared that I'd damage my cards.
Yeah, freaking
Frenchie.
Let him borrow my cards.
No, every time I see him, like, don't. Wait, there's Christian ports in there.
My caverns and your ports, and just.
Okay, so I'm gonna keep that.
Yeah, mine's decent.
Alright.
Scry.
Sweet.
I'm keeping it.
Yeah, I'm definitely going to Vegas now. So,
all right.
Good?
Yeah.
You know, just let me know, like I said, if you want us to put a deck together for you, man.
Sure. Yeah, I'm on the fence about it. Honestly, the only problem for me is that it's during the week, so I have to take time off. And I don't have any time off, so I just basically lose money. And I go to Vegas, which probably lose more money.
Crimson Viper, the real Scrody has a child and a baby mama. So I can see how that could prevent him from being able to...
His priorities are askew, I know.
Oh, isn't that Kevin Smith? You askew?
Okay.
Yep.
Go ahead.
I'm mildly annoyed by that.
I'm a fan of that on the bug over side of the table.
Okay.
Oh, got him. Tit for tat.
That's why I was okay. Ooh. Sorry, go ahead. But I was actually a spicy card I was thinking about adding to my sideboard that I've seen it before and I've never tried it is Misdirection. The card has been on the uptick.
For sure.
Sorry. Like,
missing the chalice trigger.
Okay.
I was talking, fuck!
Okay.
But see, that's why I'm a proponent of just always trying it.
You never know.
There's usually no reason not to.
Yeah.
I mean, especially when you're locked out.
Yeah.
And like, this isn't Magic Online, right? So
yeah.
People are responsible for their own.
That's correct.
Bitch.
Okay. Yeah. Pretty bad.
And And
interrupt the game.
No. Him.
Wolf him gets the ladies.
Which force it.
No, okay.
The thing is, I'm losing two cards either way, but I want to keep these cards.
Good.
Oh god. That was a sweet top deck. Back to basics.
Oh!
Might as well.
Like, I kind of locked myself out of playing the screen name, but I'll draw a land eventually, I'm hoping. And I locked three of his lands. So.
Yeah.
Wait, and I have Chalice for one,
yeah,
so his place can't even make plays, really. Go ahead. Yeah.
Brent's asking, since a-sper missed the trigger, it's legal? Technically.
Technically.
It's
annoying because the rules basically allow him to play the card and then see if I say anything. Because it is a beneficial trigger for me, he does not have to remind me.
Yeah.
Basically.
But he can't go through his own trigger.
I cannot, because it is a beneficial trigger to me. I have to remember it.
Yeah.
And if he reminds me, then I have to do it, basically, is what it comes down to.
Crimson Viper, you miss people just straight up painting you in tournaments?
Crimson Viper says, I'm thinking about returning to Burn from Shardless.
I mean, just play both, like I do.
Well, Jorgensen's asking, a-sper, would you have gotten a warning for missing a trigger?
You both would have, I think.
No,
only I would.
Really?
If I cast a spell and we both don't say something, then we would both get a warning.
Oh, okay.
It's basically how it works.
So yes to both.
Well, yes and no.
So yes, in situation.
Yes, situationally yes.
Okay.
Try Charles roll again.
God damn it!
Abrupt decay. This.
Go ahead.
Good.
Those are the words a-sper wants to hear until Brent.
Yeah. until death. Do he parts.
Crimson Viper is calling you Aspen.
What
Aspen?
I've heard it all. I've heard Asperger's. I've heard.
Well, I hadn't thought of that, but now
yeah,
that's what I'm going to call you.
Someone's called me Spermling.
Spermling.
That was a fun one.
Sperling?
Yeah, Sperling.
Baby Sperling. Yeah, that's
I mean, Ace. People call me Ace.
What's up, Ace?
Ace.
I'd be okay with that. That sounds cool.
Four.
Four?
Go ahead. It's not looking good.
That's a castable card. Have you gotten Casper?
Yeah, Casper.
Oh, damn it.
Jasper. Esper.
Oh, well, of course. That's where you kind of like that, though, right?
Yeah, that one's cool. That one could be worse. Okay, sure.
Sorcery, instant land?
Oh, artifact.
Artifact.
Benda?
Yep.
So guess we top stack the land.
A land or a... Not the worst.
A playable card.
Reveal.
Reveal the true name that I revealed earlier. And then don't attack with my lord that doesn't have island walk, but I will attack with two.
Brenton, we can probably get you any Delver type you want. Four color to bug. You just gotta pick.
Go ahead.
Don't play Rug, though. Rug's not where it's at.
I mean, I think it's
oh,
not.
Oh, Chalice would have countered the Curse Catcher, right?
Ooh.
Judge. Both get a warning. We just talked about this. 5-speed LA in there with the rules calling.
You're right, 5-speed LA.
Yeah, you're right.
They both get a warning. If they do it again, we'll flog them publicly on camera. I've got my whip.
Bant Delver? I don't know about that.
Get out of here.
Oh, gross.
Yeah.
I mean, I don't think he wins that game even if the Curse Catcher isn't there.
Yeah.
Right, but...
It just would have been that much longer.
Like, yeah, it just takes longer. Eventually I get a true name or, like, Phantasm Limage on my...
It's just funny we were talking about it the
whole
time.
Yeah,
we just let you do it.
Yeah, well, it just happened.
Sometimes it's hard to remember with Merfolk because you have Cavernous Souls, but...
Yeah, exactly. Like, I'm usually violing or caverning in my Merfolk through the Chalice, but yeah, not that game.
Sated Delver.
Yeah, this is another reason that I really like Merfolk, is just back to basics. It's just a super sweet card.
It's a house.
All right, so...
then you run into Stompy three times in a row. And,
so we're doing...